Okay. Good evening, everyone. So today is our my topic is mobile UX in Magento and how we can delight user to buy from any website, which is e-commerce or Magento websites. So I'm starting with myself, Charan Rajput, working in Ranosys Technologies in India office. And I have been working in Ranosys Technologies in the past 6 years and had worked with many global clients like UK, US, and Singapore clients. And my expertise is mainly for e-commerce and domain as fashion and retail. So now I'm moving to the agenda. Today's agenda will be about why mobile UX is important and common UX mistake and delighters and best practices for mobile UX. So I think everyone is aware about Pareto principle, 80-20 rule. Anyone? Yeah. So Pareto rule is 80% of your outcomes come from your 20% of your inputs. So whatever we do, if we from 100% task, there will be only 20% of input, which will their outcome will be 80% of the task. So here is the UX principle. If you are working on any website or you are redesigning any website, e-commerce website, then 80% of UX issues can be fixed in 20% of changes. There are many issues we can fix in any e-commerce website. It can be related to mobile experience or desktop experience. So, this is why mobile UX is important. So, I'm coming with some points. One is loyal user base. There is a huge number of mobile users. They are using mobile websites and applications. As compared to mobile applications, as we discuss about the mobile UX, especially for Magento, then Magento is providing us the responsiveness of any website. So if we are opening any responsive website and browser, we are accessing it, then user base, if I'm opening a website first time in mobile, then user experience or first impression should be very appealing. So loyal user base should be there. Next is reduce support cost. If mobile UX is good for your web application, website, or e-commerce website, then it will reduce your support cost, because anyone can access your website 24/7 in a day, and he can contact your site easily. And they can get their feedback from FAQ and other things on the website, so it reduces your support cost. Increase customer satisfaction, because we know that everything is available in mobile and it is working very fine in mobile responsive as well. So I am away from home, I can access it and can see, yes, my delivery of the product is going to be there in that day, in this time. So anything which we can access from mobile increase the satisfaction of the customer. Okay. Increase sales, because mobile, whenever we are traveling to somewhere like using MRT buses, then we use to explore the mobile and we can purchase while we are traveling. So it increased the sales, because no one have time to go to a store or stay on the laptop and work on that. So it increased the sales if mobile UX of your website is good. And it gives you edge over its competition. There are a lot of websites, many websites are there. So what difference your website, your e-commerce store has, it gives you edge over the competition. So what are the common mistakes we faced in mobile UX? One is no mobile optimization. There are many e-commerce sites which has been developed around us 4 to 5 years ago. This doesn't have mobile responsiveness. They are facing these kind of issues. So mobile, if mobile optimization is not there, you are going to lose many customers, many. Next thing, it's form suck. If your form are not good, it are not user friendly, they are going to, you are going to lose many users for because of the forms. Like you are asking an irrelevant question, or your form is not tappable in mobile, it is not user friendly, then it will be another mistake. The checkout isn't optimized. You have many things, more things on the checkout phase. You should focus on what is your product and how user is going to buy it and what are the description of the product. So whenever we are designing for mobile, then we have to think about the how a product detail is going to be there, what our key elements, what we want to sell there. So focus on the things. If you see in this ASOS, there are many things which are good, but as we see that checkout process, this is, there are multiple things and fonts are very small. So this is a problem. Another problem is user can't find what they need. If any user is coming on your website and accessing it from your mobile, their mobile, this is just because they are finding a product or they are checking for product detail. Research shipping and delivery information, when we are, our product is going to deliver, and purchase an item. So these are the things. If user is not able to do these things on your website, you are going to lose your customers. Other UX issues we see in our many Magento websites and e-commerce websites. One is poor product image quality. If your product image quality is poor, whatever product you have, it might be iPhone, or it can be anything, but its image is poor, then customer is going to lose satisfaction or belief on your product. So product image quality should be proper. One image only, many websites I have visited that they have only one image for one product, but user want to experience complete product. So we should have multiple images for any product if we are doing e-commerce website. Redirecting mobile users to desktop interface. It's been like if terms and condition, FAQ pages, we see in many websites, they are just redirecting it to desktop version. This is not good because we cannot see the font size, what it is not readable. So we should take care about that. Text that's hard to read. If you can see, this is the an website's page, and you can see this font in mobile is very small. So what are the best practices and delighters we can improve our mobile UX experience? These are few of them. There are many things. It's depend on product to project to project, how your project is developed. So I'm coming with first one and my favorite, on a image zoom gesture. Whenever you are going to search any product, you are going to see how it looks, how it feels, what is its texture of the, if you are going to buy shirt, you want to see the texture of the shirt, and you want to see the multiple view of that. So whenever you are using a product detail, you should have this zoom gesture. If you are double tapping on image, it should zoom. If you are pinching it, it should zoom. So that kind of effect, we can easily can do it in mobile application. But for mobile responsive, mobile UX, which is actually just in Magento website, which we are showing in browser, for that, we should have this mobile gesture. 90% of website do not use that gesture. So this is a problematic thing that can help a user to see how product will look. Use touch optimized keyboard layout. I'm going to fill pin code, but there is QWERTY keypad. So it is not going to help me. If I'm going to put my mobile number, phone number, so then it should be the numeric type. So we need to choose what type of input we are choosing, what type of fields, input type field we should use. It is time, it is address, URL, whatever it is, we should take care of this input keyboard. So this helps a lot to the users. AMP is most popular in e-commerce now, and Magento is in Magento website we are using that. It's higher performance and engagement. It's improves your website performance. If you are searching any product of a website in Google, whenever you will click, it will in milliseconds it will redirect to the page and product detail. So AMP is being very popular. We should use that to enhance the user experience of any Magento website. Another is collapse sign-in and place guest checkout at the top. I have visited many websites which are forcing me to sign up for the webs to purchase any item. I shouldn't. I don't want to share my details. I just want to check out as a guest. So whenever you are developing a website, checkout as a guest should be first option, and input like login and create an account should be another option. So we need to define that what is our primary action, primary output we want from a user. It is to sell the product, not to get the details of the user. So checkout as a guest should be first option. Then sign in also should be collapsed, because it is user tendency when they are looking at any mobile application, they see the input field first. So we should take care about that. It helps the user a lot and our sales goes up for the products. Another is disable autocorrect during checkout. 79% of website do not use that. So whenever I'm filling address, address name can be anything. It's a Google translator is not going to suggest it. So we should disable it. So user can easily, it is lighter for users. So we should take care of where we want to disable the suggester of the keyboard. Allow users to search within currently navigated category. Like I am searching a 77 mm. So in which category I want to search this product? If 77 mm is there, I just search that, there will be multiple options in multiple category. Like it can be 77 mm in SLR camera lenses, it can be in UV filters as well. So we should define the category while searching, that in which category you want to search that product. So this is last but not the least is home page. Whenever a user is opening your web, any website in mobile, what is user going to buy? So we should customize our home page according to the best user experience and the expected products. If I have a website which is selling bags and shoes, so I should show the best categories on homepage. User tendency is to scroll and go down to the page. So we should take care about that. So, and whenever we are developing a website, desktop application can be easily different, but for mobile responsive, we can show our popular category, popular product on homepage. So user easily can buy it. So these are all from my today. Thank you. Any query?
Any query?
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.